and gentlemen, now what we're going to do is we're going to change out the spark plugs, the final piece of the puzzle. And if this doesn't solve it, then we'll just have to dig more into it. I don't really want to get more crazy with this car. I want to get less crazy with it. First thing we're going to do anytime we mess with any of the electrical system, we're going to remove the battery. In this case, that's done. We'll disconnect right here. Last time I did this, it was a lot easier. Oh, there we go. Keep right in. Oh, there we go. Don't lose that clip. I'm not even sure if that's supposed to come off or not. And just pry it off. You see, usually what happens is on these parts of the video where I don't do a whole lot of talking, and I should be, I've gone over a million times how to go over the spark plugs, but you never know. You never know who's watching, you never know what they'll learn. So this is the coil pack that comes out again. And now we're looking at the spark plugs. Now I need to see if I even have a spark plug socket. I should. Let me go find it.
Sir. and black.
Obviously, this new turbo has been really hard on the plugs. It's this is no go. We're gonna have to change this out. You can see the porcelain's burnt, meaning that there's probably been some detonation in the motor. I've seen better. Also, the dust cover's off. This is rust. I should have never taken that dust cover off. I'm gonna take the. What we have also is that if you look in there, you kind of see that it's not very clean in there either. Well, short of redoing it, all we can really do now is just change them out. I love my cousin, but seriously, sometimes there must be some brain damage going on. We're going to go get a 5/8 spark plug for the car, and we made a quick run. I gave him a $5 bill to go get a Diet Coke, and he comes back out, and he's like, nah, give me $10, bro. I'm like, how much is a Diet Coke? He's like, Diet Coke's five something. I ain't supporting your bad habits. You know, you need to, like, get that shit under control. Anyway, here he comes. Here he comes, Walk. Here he comes. Alright, man. Here we go. Alright, what'd you get, bro?
You don't remember? You look bad? I'm just fucking a badass motherfucker.
What'd you get?
Hey, come bro. Back. I look good.
Bro, you could have just got me one from the Coke machine, man. It's okay. You didn't have to get me.
There's no Coke machine.
This shit's like 260.
There's no Coke machine. This is like bottle.
It says soda.
There's
ice.
No, puppy, there's no Coke machine.
Bro,
no Coke
it machine. Shows Coke right there on the Coke machine.
I know, but there's no Coke machine there.
Is it out of order?
I gave you priority right there.
Is it out of order?
No, I gave you priority bottled down. You want Coke machine shit? It's all fucking bottled down shit, dude. You don't want that crap. I don't want that crap. I definitely don't buy that shit.
That's my cousin, man. Hang on.
Ukraine,
bro.
All the way.
I ain't gonna Google if they have a slushy machine in there or not.
No. A slushy. But a Coke machine's a different thing.
What'd you get?
I gave you a Coke. What'd you get? I gave you my drink.
How much was that?
$3. Yeah, let me spark that shit up right there.
What is that? Wait, local.
It's a four local.
14% alcohol?
Oh my goodness, fucking drug ass motherfucker, right?
Yeah. There we go.
Eyes down shit. All is good.
What happened if I gave you that $10 bill?
I gave you some change. Actually, I gave you a $10 back. Money's not a party to me. You know, money's not a fucking party to me. If you give me a 20, I'll give you a 50. They give me a 50, I give you 100.
I love you, cuz. Alright, let's go take care of some shit.
Let's do some shit!
Let's get some lunch.
Yes, sir.
And let's go get a 5/8 spark plug so I can get my fucking hoopty ride back together. Alright, ladies and gentlemen. So now I'm going to go ahead and change out the spark plugs. So just a quick note, what spark plug gap, they recommend that this gets gapped to 0.28. Now, with the precious metal spark plugs, you have to use a feeler tool such as this. I'll be honest with you, I really don't know how to adjust a gap. So really, I'm just using this to confirm what we already have. So what you're going to do is you're going to want to pull out the spark plug. You're going to want to use your tool, find the corresponding 0.25, which is right here, and just see. As you can see, it just barely goes in there. The 0.30 is too big. 0.25 is fine. They recommend 0.28. Obviously, 0.32 is too big. You're going to want to take some of the anti-seize lubricant. You're going to put it on the threads. You don't have to get it all the way around. You just need to do a little bit like that. That might even be too much. And then, without touching the porcelain, you want to secure your spark plug tool. Onto the tip itself, and then it's ready to go in. And you're going to want to repeat this process for each of the vehicles. And you just want to do it hand tight. When you take the spark plug out, you want to do what I did in reverse. Also, it may not be a bad idea to check the prior spark gap. As you can see, the prior gap was just way too close. I can't even get the 0.28 in there. Oh, barely. Yeah, it's done. This spark plug came out a little weird. It's got some goop on it right there. Not sure what that is. Checking the gap. The gap is also too small of a gap. So they're all dirty and they're all too small of a gap, not properly gapped. And they came like this from the factory, because these are the factory plugs. So I'm not sure what is going on with that. Come on, man. Fuck. It's always the last one that fucks me up. Go. They're in. Give an inspection of the coil system. Make sure that that's good. Looking in there. If any of the springs look coiled or bind, you can use a screwdriver to just pop them back. And on they go. Once again, that goes back in. That's it. Spark plugs are swapped out. I guess before I start putting it back together,